Watch as I highlight some of the most useful capabilities of PresenterMedia. I've selected an animated graphic for this purpose just to demonstrate some of the amazing capabilities built into the solution itself. First thing we're going to do is have the ability to adjust the size of the graphic to meet your purposes. So in the bottom left, you see the animation size, and there's a slider here with the dimensions in pixels showing below. I can adjust this size down. If you'll notice in the middle of the screen, you'll see the graphic go smaller or larger, and you have that ability to scale right within the tool itself. So I'm going to leave it large just for the demonstration. If you have an animation, you can choose the number of loops by clicking on the loop area and then selecting the number of loops you want it to be. If you want it to run over and over, you'll just select infinite and you'll be done. Two of the more powerful features that I use a lot are the hue and saturation. Basically, the colors are what I usually want to adjust in most every slide. So I want to adjust the hue. And if you'll notice here, I'll use the hue. And if you'll notice in the bottom right-hand corner, there's a preview window. And what you're seeing is I've changed those clock frames from blue in the original graphic to green. And I can do the same thing then. I can adjust the saturation of those colors, make them a little bit darker. I can adjust the brightness of the graphic. Watch the shadows at the base of the little image, the little character. I can delete those completely. I can make them even more bold and strong, or somewhere in the middle, usually a good setting. The designers at PresenterMedia are really good, so I usually take their base options there as the best for most purposes. But if you'll notice at the base again of the feet of the little image, I can also add or take away reflections. And I'm going to leave them just slightly showing there. And you'll see them more clearly in my next options. By the way, you have an option to, if you have animation specifically, to save it as a GIF image, an animated GIF, or as a Flash SWF file. So you have the option based on where you're placing this image, how to use it and utilize it best. You will also have the image capability with one click to make it a transparent background, which just allows you to take the image and paste or put it on top of any color and any background without having any distortion or confusion. One of the most powerful features I use in virtually every graphic I use from them is the choose color option. I've selected choose color, and I want to use a specific background color. I'll choose this orange for demonstration. But you can use the color picker either by adding in the exact color number up above or to pick from colors within the web preferences or otherwise. Let me click a light gray. You can see some of the differences there. But it really gives you some great flexibility in order to make your graphics and your presentation stand out. So in this case, I'm going to go pick something that's not quite so aggressive. And I'll pick this aqua color. And I now have the ability to have this image by simply clicking Customize, and it'll take me to a completed project, which then I can paste directly into my PowerPoint presentation, into my website, marketing materials for print, etc. So really a great capability. You can always click Reset and start all over again if you like. Hope you've enjoyed it. I think you'll agree it's very, very flexible, very easy to use for non-graphics people like me to give me exactly what I'm looking for.